We sang together, and I was looking forward to see his show in London. My husband and I and Michael came to Las Vegas to see my show, and I was more than honored to have him. And,
did he come backstage?
He came backstage. We spent about an hour together, and he had a lot of questions for me. He was very, to me, he seemed to be like, I want to know so much. I want to know how it is to be in Las Vegas. How it is, Celine, to sing every night here. Is it difficult? Is it difficult to sing here every night? Is it demanding? I felt that he wanted to know so much. And me, I wanted to know so much. I wanted to know so much from him. But it seemed to me so fragile. And he wanted to have questions answered. And I was amazed to have him in my dressing room.
When you're performing and you have someone like that in the audience, are you constantly aware of his presence?
Absolutely. You cannot do otherwise. And I have to say that I was questioning myself through the whole show. Can I announce him? Do I give him his private time? Am I going to abuse of him of his time to announce him? Should I? I want to do it so much. And I did, and I did announce him, and the whole Coliseum, the whole crowd went crazy, because Michael Jackson was not only an extremely talented person, he was unique, and he was a genius. And when I said, ladies and gentlemen, Michael Jackson is with us tonight, I thought people were going to jump up the balcony. The people went crazy, and I have to say, it is such a loss, because Right now, we're home and we're watching images, and it feels like when Kennedy died, when Elvis Presley died, we're not only talking about a talented person dying. It's an amazing loss.
Well, the Presley comparison is obvious, right? They're in the same age group. Both of them shocked the world. Both of them totally unexpected passing.
Absolutely, and I have to say that my sympathy goes to the family. It's a big loss, and I have to say that it's not even sinking in right now. It's just like I'm looking at the image on TV, and my son is 8 years old, and he's got his song. He knows his name. He's listening to his song, but it's brand new for him. Like, I'm rediscovering Michael Jackson again. I grew up with him. And through my son, I'm discovering his music again. He will never die. He will never, never, ever die.
Celine,
my sympathy goes to his whole family.
From a performer's opinion, I'm not going to keep you long. From a performer's opinion, what was his greatness? Was he a great singer?
I think he was just an amazing genius. Dancing, singing. And I think it's so unfortunate, Larry, because since he's very little, he's under pressure. I think we all live under pressure differently. We live under pressure because we want to give the audience and the fans what they look forward, what they expect. We want to do a better album. We want to do a better show. I think Michael Jackson lived under pressure all the time since he's 5 years old, wanting to please his family, his fans, and putting the bar so high that even like he needed to be surpassing his own self. And I think it's unfortunate because the pressure was so tremendous. I am so sure. If you only live under pressure and you don't have something like your family, your husband or your wife, your children. I mean, he probably lived so much. He didn't have the balance.
Yeah. Celine, you're a doll. I thank you so much for
I am sorry. My sympathy to the whole family, and it's a big loss for all of us.
Celine Dion. Celine Dion set records at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas in a brand new room. I saw her there. She was terrific. In that same room, I saw another performer who was also terrific, and she's going to be with us right after the break. That's